know what I have found.
Runway ready. The teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad and given to us by the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan offers a universal message that gives healing to all who will receive it. Bearing witness to this, we have a sister aged 21 representing two members of our family, the Mexican and the Black. She will share her testimony of her growth and development as a third generation member of the Nation of Islam. Please welcome Sister Safia Muhammad.
En el nombre de Allah, el benéfico, el misericordioso, soy testigo que no existe un Dios más que Allah y que Muhammad es su mensajero. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah and that Muhammad is his messenger. I greet you all in the greeting words of peace. We say it in the Arabic language. As-salamu alaykum. I was fortunate to be born from two very great people, the Mexican and the Black. Our Latino and Black community have suffered unlike any other people on our planet, especially the woman. We are living proof that we are one sisterhood and one family. Praise be to Allah. With the help of Allah, who is the one God, I will share with you my ongoing process into becoming a Muslim woman in the greatest nation on the planet Earth, the Nation of Islam. I was blessed to be born in the Nation of Islam, and I am blessed to be the granddaughter of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Although I was born into this great nation, I had to make a decision for myself to accept the teachings and become registered. I recently accepted Islam and cannot thank Allah enough for giving to us the Most Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, for he is our example of the two that back him, Master Farad Muhammad and the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. He is a divine teacher and guide. I thank my mother and father for instilling in me the love for Allah, who came in the person of Master Farad Muhammad, love for the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, and love for the Most Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. I also thank my grandmother, Mother Tainetta Muhammad, who helped to guide me with knowledge and wisdom. Praise be to Allah. I thank her for helping me in my growth in Islam and for giving me the best example of what it is to be a Muslim woman. I learned through her the impact of the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad on the various cultures and people around our planet. She traveled the world and found Islam and the teachings in every culture she encountered. This to me is the definition of love. Her love and faith in Allah was what kept her moving. It was what she lived for and stood by no matter the consequence. That love is what made her to be the woman that she was and still is. My faith and love for Allah grew over time and continues to grow. There was a time that I did not see my purpose in life, and absolutely nothing really fulfilled me. No one could get me back on my feet at a time where I truly felt lost, but Allah Himself. I blamed everyone around me for my wrongdoings. As my father, Minister Ishmael, said in his speech last week, we're always looking for somebody to blame for our misfortunes in life. We have to accept our responsibilities. My misfortunes were put in front of me for a meaning and purpose that at the time I did not understand. Islam and the teachings of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad taught me that there is no such thing as a coincidence. A coincidence is a striking occurrence of two or more events at one time, apparently by mere chance. Occurrences, chances, and events do not happen without Allah's active or permissive will. Allah gave us the ability to make our own choices. He gave us the freedom to make our own decisions. We know by nature what is right and what is wrong. And when we make a wrong choice or decision, we do not like to accept the consequences that follow. My choices in life were not the best choices, but they have gotten me to a point in my life where I am thankful for the life that has been given to me. My greatest choice was accepting the teachings and become a registered Muslim. All praise is due to Allah. Finding my purpose in life was and is one of the most difficult paths I have to take, but it is most difficult when God is absent. My faith in Allah has guided me to study early childhood education. And I cannot find a greater purpose for my life than helping our children grow into the knowledge of self, guided by the teachings. I have been blessed beyond measure, and I pray that my love continues to grow for Allah and His people. My love for Him grows as I realize through the teachings that my life is not my life. My life belongs to Him. From Him I came, and to Him I shall return. I also pray that you will be greatly inspired today and find something that the minister says to us that will help you and I pursue our purposes in life. Thank you for listening. As I leave, as I came. Assalamu alaikum.
Absolutely beautiful. The Bible, in the book of Proverbs 31:10, reads, "Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies." To be virtuous means having or showing high moral standards. Our next presenter is a shining example of just that. At age 17, she is a senior and honor student at Muhammad University of Islam. Yes. She is another of our young, powerful voices in the student ministry class. She will speak to us of the value of being a virtuous woman. Please receive Sister Taira Muhammad.
In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. I greet you all in the greeting words of peace. Assalamu alaikum. The Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad says to the black man to protect and elevate your woman. There is no nation on earth that has less respect for and as little control of their women as we, the so-called Negroes here in America. Now, we do not mean control in the sense of a man hindering you. Control in this sense is a means to protect. A woman would not mind the control of a man if he is under the control of God, because he will not exercise his authority wickedly. He will be just in all of his doings. Mothers, if you have a child, would you say you can truly protect your daughter or son if they are not under your control? No, not to hinder your child, but to protect it from harm or danger, as it is with a man. But why is it that there is no respect for us black women? It is because ever since we were brought to the States as slaves, we have lost the knowledge of who we are. But we are the mothers and fathers of civilization. When you look at the condition of the black man and woman of America, we are a destroyed people because the woman is disrespected and unprotected. We are destroyed because we are not elevating the black woman. Praise be to Allah. Elevate means to improve morally, intellectually, or culturally, to uplift. But this world isn't elevating us. Instead, they have us preoccupied with TV shows like Scandal or Orange is the New Black. Now, I'm not condemning you for watching it, but what kind of message is it portraying? They are promoting the behavior of scandalous women constantly into our minds, into the minds of our children, and we think that this is okay. This is why we are taught a nation can rise no higher than its woman, but a nation cannot rise if we have an ignorant woman. So the black woman must be taught, praise be to Allah. The black woman must be taught the divine and immeasurable value of herself. Today, we grow up in a world that glorifies the woman for her body instead of glorifying the woman for her mind as the second self of God. We are God's helper, and he intended for us to be his helpmeet. But we do not understand the power of our mind or the sacredness of our bodies. This is why, as women, we should cover ourselves in all of our adornments, because we know that attracts the man physically, but the physical can lose its form. Now, there is nothing wrong with physical attraction, because it is in accordance with the divine law of nature. But you want a man to be attracted to the beauty of your mind. What good is a pretty woman, praise be to Allah. What good is a pretty woman who can't cook or keep a clean home or help their man? It is what's on the inside, praise be to Allah, that attracts the kind of man that we want. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan says, "A man should never have you just to have you. He's got to be worthy of you, or he's not worth having you. Peace be to Allah. Look on the media and on social networks. How are we portrayed, black woman? We are depicted as the lowest of civilization. And sometimes we don't even love ourselves enough to think before we post videos of us twerking or fighting each other over petty things, and then we find it entertaining or amusing. So we dress and act, praise be to Allah, as our enemy desires, but not how God desires. We degrade ourselves in our conversation. We are not thoughts. We are not hoes, and we are not female dogs. We are the queens of the kingdom of God, praise be to Allah. Praise be to Allah. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan teaches, it takes a reformed woman to make a reformed nation. And there will never be a righteous kingdom until and unless there is a righteous woman. Where there are no decent women, there are no decent men. But we must be made decent, and we must be made virtuous. This is why Master Farid Muhammad came to sit us on top of civilization, and he gave us this class, which is dedicated to teaching the value of a virtuous woman. What is a virtuous woman, and what does it mean to be virtuous? The Quran talks about virtuous women like Mary in Surah 3. O Mary, surely Allah has chosen thee and purified thee, and chosen thee above the women of the world. In the Bible, it goes into what it means to be virtuous. Proverbs 31. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband safely trusts in her. She brings wool and flax. She brings her food from afar and provides it for her family. She gives to the poor, and she is strong and dignified. This scripture defines and describes a woman that is steady in her duty to God, herself, and her family. Being virtuous does not just mean the physical purity, but it is about the purity of the mind and the character of that woman. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan says that the value of a virtuous woman is worth more than the value of the wealth of the earth. So let us make Mary today, praise be to Allah, our example in our doings, and keep her in the forefront of our mind so we can be our true, valuable selves. I came, I leave as I came, in the greeting words of peace. Assalamu alaikum.
Oh, praises be to Allah. Our next presentation is on drill, which is an exercise that instills discipline. We can amass great knowledge, but knowledge in the absence of discipline cannot be put to use for our benefit. Please welcome a sister who oversees the training of our women and girls, ages 16 to 35, called the MGT Vanguard. She is a sister and a soldier. Please welcome Sister Kabasa Muhammad.
In the name of God, whom we refer to as Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, we thank him for Moses, we thank him for Jesus, we thank him for the scriptures they brought, we thank him for Muhammad and the Quran. We thank Allah for all those who struggled and sacrificed of themselves to see the people free. We can never thank God enough for raising up one from among us, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, to lead, teach, and guide us to the straight path of God. And I would be at fault if I did not thank Allah for the leader, teacher, and guide, the boldest, bravest, most fearless man among us today, who gives his life daily to serve not just black people, but all oppressed people of the earth. I'm talking about none other than the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. Praise be to Allah. In a few moments, sisters will come before you to demonstrate military drill. Drill is an exercise that we practice in the Nation of Islam that requires mind and body coordination. It compels the habits of obedience, which teaches us self-control. It is the foundation of disciplinary training. It teaches us to be dutiful, learning how to obey and execute a command as we hear it. In the Nation of Islam, we are taught to obey those in authority among us and obey non-believers in authority over us as long as it does not conflict with our religion. In drill, we are given commands that we are made to obey. Although the command may come to us from our sister, it helps us to train our mind to respond to the ultimate command that comes from the highest in command, God Himself. All praise is due to Allah. Regardless to our religious choice, as women and girls, we all need the command of God to discipline, mold, and shape us into the women that God desires for us to be. Being able to respond to God's command allows us to not be guided by those who don't have the same intentions as God. When we submit and allow ourselves to be obedient, we will be treated with the greatest of respect. Because of the command we follow, we will demand respect. We won't be defined by what we are portrayed as on TV's Atlanta's Housewives or our sisters on Love & Hip Hop. You know what I'm talking about, right? That is reality TV, but that is not the reality that God desires for His women, and we are His women. All praise is due to Allah. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan said that there will be no righteous kingdom until there is a righteous woman. With discipline, obedience, and by submitting to the right command, we can be this woman that will help to produce this righteous kingdom. Are you ready to witness this great exercise that is the foundation of disciplinary training? First, we will share with you a video presentation that demonstrates discipline through drill and self-defense. Now, I am honored to introduce to you the MGT and GCC Vanguard drill team of Mosque Mariam.
A tin hut. Vanguard.
Yes, ma'am.
Move.
Vanguard.
Palm from the MGT padded soldiers, you'll never see. Stand up straight, say nothing but God. Strong and steady, soldiers, are you ready? Everywhere we go, people wanna know who we are, and so we tell them. Your left flank march, your left flank march, double left flank march. Flank ways to the red march. Series two, move. Doubters, get out our way. Hypocrites, we keep at bay. Muhammad, we obey, get down on our knees and pray. Judgment, the day is near.
Saviors are here.
Vanguard's the name, queens, we reign. In ranks, we range, ain't playing games. Count, Cadence, count.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
The leg, Cadence, count your Cadence, count your Cadence, count them all. Belief in one God and exalted Christ. Obey apostle, bring the dead to life. Count, count, Muhammad. It's been heard and it's been said,
Elijah Muhammad and the teachings are dead.
But the mighty vanguard here still gives
all the proof that he still lives.
Am I right or wrong?
Right.
Are we weak or strong?
We're strong.
Am I right or wrong?
Right. We follow Farrakhan.
Lost Found Muslim Lesson Number 1, Question and Answer 14. What is the meaning of MGT and GCC? Answer: Muslim Girls Training and General Civilization Class. This was the name given to the training of women and girls in North America. How to keep house. how to rear their children, how to take care of their husbands, sew, cook, and in general, how to act at home and abroad. These training units were named by our prophet and leader of Islam, W.D. Farah.
We are taught how to sew. We are taught the dressing room of our ancestors, so now we dress in a way where men could not know the beauty of our form, but they will come to know the beauty of our mind, of our expression, of our face. We make our clothes and do not allow Satan to dress us and degrade us. We are taught how to cook. We are taught how to rear our children. We are taught how to take good care of that black man. All right, MGT. So we thank Allah for the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, because they said that the black woman must be highly educated, cultivated, refined, respected, and protected.
The seven units of the MGT and GCC. How to keep house. We keep our mind and body clean as the real house of God, and translate this same level of care to our homes. How to rear their children. We work to produce children who reflect God. How to take care of their husbands. We serve as our husband's helpmeet in building a strong family, community, and nation. Fabric of Allah God, we seek to cut out our lives according to His divine pattern. How to cook. The science of food equips us to be the doctors, nurses, and nutritionists in our homes. How to act at home. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad taught us that the home is your base, not necessarily your place, but that's where it starts. Everything begins at home. When you teach a man, you only teach an individual, but when you teach a woman, you teach a nation. How to act abroad. We represent the height of grace, beauty, and civilization.
Now, my sisters, you don't let no man take from you what you don't wish to give. Now you have to fight for your dignity. Don't let no man, I don't care if he put a gun to your head. He wants from you what you don't want to give. Kill it. Kill him. But say, Allahu Akbar. power, and I guarantee you his knees will buckle.
Yes, sir.
He come near you with a penis, cut it off.
Yes, sir.
Cut his throat. Won't give him nothing.
Yes, sir.
But death.
Yes, sir.
Because that's what a rapist deserves.
Yes, sir.
Great responsibility of raising our young women as the leaders of the new world order, walking beside our men, that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad said that he could make us so beautiful and so well trained that he could send us out to the world in committees. With that training and the world's attention would be on our women, whether it was in China, these are his words from those table talks, or any part of the world, and the people would come and say, who is this? And want to know, where did we come from? And they would recognize us by our expression of love and joy, etiquette, cleanliness, good manners, and that our women, we are the key, he has said. This is the field for the birthing of that new world order.